Now, what is the average current? Therefore, average current IA is equals to Q by T. Q by T. What is Q by T? Now, the net charge passing through a conductor perpendicular to the cross-sectional area in the unit time is called average current. Now, this is the conductor. I am applying the battery, right? This is called any cross-sectional area. The amount of net charge, the amount of net charge passing through cross-sectional area, then in a unit time is called average current. Therefore, the net charge passing through a conductor perpendicular to the cross-sectional area in a unit time is called average current. Now, what is the instantaneous current? In a small interval of time, delta T. What is the amount of charge passing? Delta Q. Now, this is called average current. For average current, there is a particular limiting value. Whenever we are calculating the limiting value, the condition is delta T tends to zero. Then it is called, what to say, instantaneous current. Now this is called average current. Delta Q by delta T is called average current. Now this is called limiting value of average current. Now this is called limiting value of average current. As delta T tends to zero is called instantaneous current. Now, the current defined in a duration of the time is called average current. The current defined at a particular instant of time is called instantaneous current. Whenever the rate of flow of charge is constant, average current is defined. Whenever the rate of flow of charge is not constant, instantaneous current is defined. Again, the currents are two types. Constant currents and variable currents. For constant currents, right? Average current is equals to, that is instantaneous current. Now, generally, right, in this, current is defined, I is equals to, what to say, Q by T. Right? Now, here, now, what is the unit of current? What is the unit of current? What is the formula? I is equals to Q by T. Right? What is the unit of charge? Coulomb. By. What is the time? Second. Right? That equals to coulomb by second. Therefore, coulomb by per second. This coulomb per second is called ampere. This coulomb per second is called ampere. Therefore, the unit of current is called ampere. The SI unit of current is called ampere. Now, what is the definition of ampere? Ampere is equals to, what to say? That is 1 coulomb per second. What is the definition of ampere? If 1 coulomb of charge is passing through the conductor perpendicular to the cross-sectional area in 1 second, then the current is said to be 1 ampere. Already 1 ampere is equals to 1 coulomb per second. Right? That means 1 ampere is equals to 1 coulomb of charge is nothing but 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons by 1 second. That means if 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are passing through the conductor perpendicular to the cross sectional area in 1 second, then the current is said to be 1 ampere. That means, let us consider this is a conductor. Right? Now, in 1 second, 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are entered into the conductor. At the same time, in the 1 second, 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are left out from the conductor. Then the current is said to be 1 ampere. That means, in 1 second, 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons as a whole, they are not moving. That means in 1 second, right? How many number of electrons are entered into the conductor? 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. In the same time, how many number of electrons left out from the conductor means 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 number of electrons. As a result, the net number of electrons in the conductor remains constant. Here, this many number of electrons are entered into the conductor, same number of electrons are left out from the conductor. As a result, the total number of electrons in the conductor remains constant. Suppose, let us consider, in 1 second, 2 into 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are entered into the conductor. At the same 1 second, 2 into 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are left out from the conductor, then the current is said to be 2 amperes. Similarly, for understanding purpose, 3 into 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are entered into the conductor. In the same 1 second, 3 into 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons are left out from the conductor, then the current is said to be 3 amperes. Now, the ampere, 1 ampere is equals to 1 coulomb per second, or 1 ampere is equals to 6.25 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons per second. Next one. Now, here, current. Current is a scalar or vector. Which one is right? Now, here, current is scalar. Current is the scalar. Why? Because current has a magnitude, right? Current has a direction, but it does not obey, laws of vector addition. Therefore, instead of treating as a vector, current is said to be a scalar. Generally, what is the definition of the scalar? The physical quantity which has magnitude is called scalar quantity. Now, what is the vector definition? The physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction and obeying the laws of vector addition, then such a physical quantity is said to be vector quantity. Here current is there, it has the magnitude, it has the direction, but it is not obeying the laws of vector addition. It is not obeying the parallelogram law of vectors. It is not at all obeying the right polygon law of vectors. It is not at all obeying the triangular law of vectors. Hence, the current is a scalar quantity instead of vector. Now, next, current can be measured by ammeter. Current can be measured by ammeter. Right? Current can be measured by milliammeter. Current can be measured by microammeter.